Welcome, everybody. I'm going to provide you with a quick overview and demo of Viavi's OCC 4056 DWDM verifier. It provides a channel checker, spectral analysis, and SFP test and tune capability in a single module. That's why we say it's more than a DWDM channel checker. So this is the module right here. And that module has flexibility to be attached to either our T-Bird 2000 version 2 mainframe, which holds one module at a time, our T-Bird 4000 version 2 mainframe that holds two modules at a time, or our T-Bird 5800 version 2, which is our Ethernet business services tester, which can hold one module at a time. All right. The module provides your traditional DWDM channel checker capability in that it will auto-identify any DWDM channel on the fiber and provide the individual power level of each detected channel. But it goes above and beyond a traditional channel checker in that it also will measure actual wavelength and provide an offset and drift measurement. And then secondly, it actually, as you can see here, has two SFP bays on the top of the unit. And so this gives me some additional capabilities, which include the ability to use the SFP as a light source, the ability to test out my SFPs, which I'll demo to you shortly, and the ability to tune my SFPs, assuming that the SFP is using the industry standard MSA tuning method. So with that, I'm going to quickly move over to the test set itself and provide a quick demo. So in this case, I'm using a T-Bird 4000 demo unit, which, as I mentioned earlier, can hold two modules. So here is my OCC 4056C module. As a quick FYI, I also have my DWDM OTBR with WaveScan, a Viavi patented feature, as the second module. We have a separate video for that that you can view. But the point here is I can potentially have both modules attached, and I have all DWDM test capabilities I need on a single test set. So let me go into the OCC 4056C by simply tapping it. When I do that, if I'm in the real world, I would connect my fiber to the OCC 4056C and then simply push the start button on the test set. I am not on a real network right now, but I do have this trace that was run from a real network just so you can see what the results look like. So after I run the scan, you can see here I get a spectral view and a table view. It's telling me 12 total channels were detected, and now it's providing the traditional DWDM channel checker capabilities in that here's my detected channels, here's the individual power levels for those detected channels. I have the ability to move up and down and see them as I desire, but what we provide that the traditional channel checker does not give you is we actually then go and measure actual wavelength, compare it to the spec wavelength for that channel, and from that we can provide an offset or a drift measurement. This has been a critical need the field has been asking for, because in the world of DWDM, with the channels being so tightly spaced, often under 1 nanometer between channels and sometimes less than half a nanometer between channels, this becomes a critical measurement to be able to detect in the field. So we can provide that. And then the other thing here is you'll notice I have the ability to view the results any way I desire. In this case, I have a split trace table view, but I can easily, if I prefer, just have a table only so I don't have to scroll up and down. And here's all my 12 channels in this case and all the information for those channels. All right. Then the second part of this, as you remember, is I told you we have SFP bays on the top of the unit. So what I can do here is I'm going to actually insert an SFP into one of the bays on the module. And when I do that, it populates the information for that SFP. It reads the SFP and tells me in this case I have a Lumentum and it is a tunable SFP. So this is the three additional capabilities we talked about because of the SFP bay being on the unit. First, I can simply turn the SFP on directly from the test set. So now it becomes a light source for me for whatever channel the SFP in this case on channel 44. All right. Secondly, I have the ability to actually I'm going to run a loop from the a fiber jumper from the transmit of the SFP port, plug it in there, and then the other end of the fiber connected into the receive port of the OCC 4056C. And now I have the ability to test my SFP. So now that I've run that jumper, I can turn my SFP on directly from the test set. And then I simply push the start key on the T-Bird to have the OCC 4056 run a scan for me. And there it is. All right, I'm still in table mode, but here's my split view. And it's telling me, yep, I see you. I detected channel 44 with this power, this offset. And so that's a quick and easy way for me to test my SFPs are good. And then lastly, I have the ability to then go in and if it's a tunable, once again, following the industry MSA tuning method, to actually tune the SFP directly from the test set. So in this case, I'll just randomly pick channel 28, and now it is tuned it directly from the test set. Typically, we then want to run that jumper back and run an SFP test again to that I previously showed you. So I'm going to have the 4056 run a scan again to confirm that it is, yes, it is tuned, successfully tuned to channel 28, outputting at this power and this offset. So this optic looks good. I can then remove it from the test set and put it into my network, and it is now tuned to channel 28, and all the measurements look good, that it's a good optic. So those are the capabilities on the OCC 4056C, and hopefully this was helpful, and I appreciate your time.